The digital world is rapidly expanding, and with that expansion comes an ever-growing threat to our data and systems. Cybersecurity isn't just about protecting ones and zeros, it's about safeguarding our privacy, our finances, and the critical infrastructure we rely on every day. If you're reading this, you're likely drawn to this challenge, ready to become a guardian of the digital realm. You're in the right place. At 3V Learning Center, we're committed to equipping aspiring cybersecurity professionals with the knowledge and skills they need to excel. Whether you're just starting out or looking to advance your career, a firm grasp of cybersecurity principles is paramount. It's the bedrock upon which all other cybersecurity knowledge is built. That's why we're diving deep into Domain 1 of the ISC2 Certified in Cybersecurity CC Certification Security Principles. This certification is a globally recognized mark of excellence, demonstrating your competence and commitment to the field. But beyond the exam itself, the concepts covered in Domain 1 are the essential tools you'll carry throughout your entire cybersecurity journey. Imagine a bank with no locks, a hospital with open access to patient records, or a power grid controlled by a single, unprotected computer. These scenarios seem unthinkable, almost absurd, yet they illustrate the critical importance of security principles in our increasingly digital world. Every connected device, every piece of data transmitted online, represents a potential vulnerability. Cybercriminals are constantly evolving their tactics, seeking to exploit weaknesses and gain unauthorized access to valuable information. That's why a strong foundation in security principles is non-negotiable. These principles provide a framework for understanding threats, assessing vulnerabilities, and implementing effective countermeasures. They are the guiding light that helps us navigate the complex landscape of cyber risks and make informed decisions to protect our digital assets. Domain 1 of the CC exam is your gateway to mastering these essential security principles. It covers a wide range of topics, from fundamental concepts like confidentiality, integrity, and availability, the CIA triad, to risk management processes, security controls, and the ethical responsibilities of a cybersecurity professional. Throughout this course, we'll break down each of these topics into digestible segments, providing you with clear explanations, real-world examples, and practical tips to solidify your understanding. We'll delve into the different types of security controls, explore the intricacies of risk assessment and treatment, and emphasize the importance of adhering to the highest ethical standards. Our goal is to empower you with the knowledge and confidence to not only ace the CC exam, but, more importantly, to embark on a successful and fulfilling career in cybersecurity. So buckle up, get ready to learn, and let's dive into the fascinating world of security principles. Let's begin our journey into Domain 1 by unraveling the first strand of the CIA triad, confidentiality. Confidentiality ensures sensitive information remains hidden from unauthorized eyes. Think of it as a digital vault, safeguarding valuable data. Encryption scrambles messages into unreadable codes. Access controls limit who can view or modify data. Data classification applies security measures based on sensitivity. Regular audits and training ensure ongoing confidentiality. Section 2. Maintaining the chain of trust integrity. Integrity ensures data remains accurate and unaltered. Imagine receiving a message from your bank. How can you be sure it's genuine? Hashing algorithms verify data integrity. They generate unique digital fingerprints. Even slight changes alter the hash value. This alerts us to tampering. Integrity is crucial in finance, healthcare, and more. It ensures reliable transactions and accurate records. Section 3. Ensuring access when it matters most. Availability. Availability ensures information and systems are accessible when needed. Imagine a hospital's system crashing during surgery or an online retailer's site going down. These scenarios highlight the importance of availability. It's about minimizing downtime and ensuring timely access. Building resilience into systems helps them withstand failures. Redundancy and backups are key principles. Organizations can quickly switch to backups during failures. Data backups ensure information can be restored. Disaster recovery plans outline responses to major incidents. Availability is a necessity in today's interconnected world. Our reliance on digital systems demands high availability. organizations invest in robust infrastructure and disaster recovery plans. Section 1. Verifying Identity, the Role of Authentication. The CIA triad forms the bedrock of information security. Think of it as the foundation of a secure house. Confidentiality, integrity, and availability ensure the walls are strong. But who has the keys? That's where authentication comes in. Authentication verifies identity. It's the security guard checking IDs. In the digital realm, it includes passwords, biometrics, and MFA. Passwords are common but weak. Weak passwords are vulnerabilities. MFA adds extra security. It requires multiple forms of ID. Authentication safeguards our digital lives. Robust authentication is essential in a connected world. Ensuring accountability, non-repudiation in action. Imagine receiving an email from a colleague denying they sent you an important document, or a customer claiming they never placed an online order. Non-repudiation ensures actions or communications can't be denied. It's about creating a digital trail of evidence. Think of it as a digital signature confirming identity and integrity. Digital signatures are a common method for non-repudiation. They create a unique, tamper-proof seal verifying identity. Non-repudiation is crucial in legal contracts, financial transactions, and more. It ensures accountability and builds trust in digital interactions. Safeguarding personal information, the importance of privacy. In an interconnected world, privacy is paramount. It's about protecting personal information and having control over your data. Data minimization and transparency are key principles. Privacy is a fundamental human right. As cybersecurity professionals, we must protect it. Understanding the risk management process. Now that we've explored the fundamental concepts of confidentiality, integrity, availability, authentication, non-repudiation, and privacy, it's time to delve into a critical process that underpins all cybersecurity efforts: risk management. Picture this. You're building a fortress, and you've got strong walls, watchful guards, and secure gates. But what good are these defenses if you don't know where the enemy is most likely to attack, or which areas are most vulnerable to a breach? That's where risk management comes in. It's not just about building defenses, it's about strategically allocating resources to mitigate the most significant threats. It's about understanding that we can't eliminate all risks, but we can make informed decisions to minimize their potential impact. Think of it as a continuous cycle of identifying, assessing, and treating risks to your organization's valuable assets. This process is not a one-time event, it's an ongoing journey that evolves alongside the threat landscape. As new technologies emerge, as cyber criminals devise new attack vectors, as your organization's assets and priorities change, so too must your risk management strategy adapt. Section 2. Identifying the threats. Shining a light on vulnerabilities. The first step in the risk management process is identification. It's about shining a light on the potential threats and vulnerabilities that could compromise your organization's security. Imagine you're a detective investigating a crime scene. Your first task is to gather evidence, to understand what happened and who might be responsible. Similarly, in risk identification, we're looking for clues that could point to potential weaknesses in our systems or processes. We're asking questions like, what are our most valuable assets? What are the potential threats to those assets? How could someone exploit those threats to gain unauthorized access or disrupt our operations? This process involves looking both internally and externally. Internally, we might examine our systems for software vulnerabilities, weak passwords, or inadequate access controls. Externally, we might consider factors like the current threat landscape, the motivations of potential attackers, and the vulnerabilities of our third-party vendors. Section 3. Assessing the impact, weighing likelihood and consequences. Assess potential risks by considering their likelihood and consequences. Understand how likely a vulnerability is to be exploited and its impact. Assign risk ratings based on predefined criteria. High likelihood and impact require immediate attention. Low likelihood and impact might be acceptable. Section 4. Taking action. Choosing the right risk treatment strategy. The final stage in the risk management process is treatment. develop strategies to mitigate, transfer, accept, or avoid risks. Mitigation reduces risk impact, transfer shifts it to a third party. Acceptance acknowledges risk without action, avoidance eliminates it. Building the defenses, understanding security controls. We've identified the enemy, assessed their capabilities, and now it's time to build our defenses. In the realm of cybersecurity, those defenses take the form of security controls. These are the measures we put in place to mitigate risks, protect our assets, and ensure the confidentiality, integrity, and availability of our information systems. Think of security controls as the layers of protection surrounding a castle. You have the outer walls, the moat, the drawbridge, the guard towers, and the soldiers patrolling the ramparts. Each layer plays a specific role in deterring, detecting, and responding to threats. Similarly, security controls in cybersecurity encompass a wide range of measures, from technical solutions like firewalls and intrusion detection systems to administrative policies and procedures that govern user behavior. These controls work together, forming a comprehensive security posture that's greater than the sum of its parts. Understanding the different types of security controls, their strengths and limitations, and how they work together is crucial for building a robust security architecture. Technical controls, the front line of cyber defense. Technical controls are the front line of defense in cybersecurity. They protect our systems and data from unauthorized access and threats. Firewalls act as barriers controlling network traffic. Intrusion detection systems monitor for suspicious activity. Encryption scrambles data, protecting it from unauthorized access. Administrative controls, setting the rules of engagement. Administrative controls are policies, procedures, and guidelines that govern behavior within an organization. They define how employees handle sensitive information and respond to security incidents. Security awareness training educates employees about threats and safe practices. Access control policies define who can access information based on roles. Change management ensures IT changes are planned, tested, and secure. The ethical imperative, why it matters in cybersecurity. Cybersecurity isn't just about tools and techniques. Ethics play a crucial role. Imagine a locksmith using their skills to burglarize homes, or a doctor harming patients. Cybersecurity professionals hold a unique position of trust. We must use our skills to protect, not exploit. The ISC2 Code of Ethics guides us in making ethical decisions. Principles in action, breaking down the ISC2 code. The ISC2 Code of Ethics is built on four principles guiding cybersecurity professionals. 1. Protect society and the infrastructure. 2. Act honorably and legally. 3. Provide competent service. And 4. Advance the profession. Section 3. Navigating ethical dilemmas, real-world challenges. Real-world situations are often complex and nuanced. Ethical dilemmas may arise where different principles conflict. Imagine discovering a security vulnerability in your company's software. You're obligated to protect both employer and customer interests, or being asked to implement a flawed security measure. Do you follow orders or speak up? These are real-world challenges cybersecurity professionals face. The ISC2 Code of Ethics provides a framework for decision-making. Section 1. Connecting the dots, how security principles shape your cybersecurity journey. Security principles are the threads weaving the fabric of cybersecurity, forming the foundation for all knowledge and skills. The CIA triad, confidentiality, integrity, availability, is the cornerstone of this foundation. These principles guide our approach to protecting information assets and making informed decisions about risk management. Cybersecurity is not just about technology, it's also about people and ethical decision-making. We are guardians of trust, protecting data, privacy, and society's well-being. Section 2, Beyond the Exam, the real-world impact of Domain 1 knowledge. While the ISC2 Certified in Cybersecurity, CC exam, is an important milestone on your cybersecurity journey, It's essential to remember that the true value of Domain 1 knowledge extends far beyond the testing center. These principles are not just abstract concepts, they are the tools you will use every day to make a real-world impact in your chosen field. Imagine yourself as a cybersecurity analyst, investigating a data breach. Your understanding of the CIA triad will guide your investigation as you seek to determine what data was compromised, confidentiality, whether the data was altered, integrity, and how the breach impacted the organization's operations, availability. Or picture yourself as a security consultant, advising a company on how to improve their security posture. Your knowledge of risk management will help you identify vulnerabilities, assess potential threats, and recommend appropriate security controls to mitigate those risks. And your understanding of the ISC2 Code of Ethics will ensure that your recommendations are not just technically sound, but also ethically responsible. Section 3. Your next steps, resources and guidance for continued success. As you move forward on your cybersecurity journey, remember that learning is a continuous process. The threat landscape is constantly evolving, with new technologies, new attack vectors, and new challenges emerging all the time. To stay ahead of the curve, you'll need to embrace lifelong learning, constantly seeking out new knowledge, skills, and perspectives. The good news is that you don't have to go it alone. There are a wealth of resources available to support your continued growth and development, from online courses and certifications to industry conferences and professional organizations. 3V Learning Center is committed to providing you with the guidance and resources you need to succeed in this exciting and ever-evolving field. Our website, www.3vlearningcenter.com, is a great place to start. There you'll find a wealth of information on cybersecurity topics, including study guides, practice exams, and articles on the latest industry trends. We also offer a variety of training courses, both online and in person, to help you deepen your knowledge and prepare for industry certifications like the ISC2 CC. If you found this helpful, make sure to like, share, and subscribe. Drop your questions in the comments below. We're here to help you succeed. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next session.